Good morning, everybody. Now I just want to discuss about I2C based ADC device, ADC and as well as DAC, and how to use this I2C based ADC device for our application development. And as a master, I am going to use 8051 microcontroller and slave, which is ADC device. Now I'll give the complete explanation about ADC device, which is works with 8051 microcontroller as a master and ADC or DAC as a slave device. So this is very simple. So now previously people will followed parallel ADCs for applications whenever they are looking to work with analog sensors or analog applications. So they depended mostly on parallel ADCs like ADC 0804 or 0808. Now this is a serial ADC. You can replace this serial ADC by knowing I2C protocol completely. You can implement this ADC device by using I2C communication. So let's go for complete explanation of this ADC device and how many pins for this device. And so what are the individual pins of this PCF8591? So this is the device from Philips Corporation, which is used to analog to digital conversion and as well as digital to analog conversion also. So PCF8591 consists of 16 pins, and which is available with DIP package. So you know already DIP means dual inline package, which consists of 16 pins and starts from first one. First pin is which is analog input 0. So this analog input 0, analog input 1, analog input 3, analog input 3, so which are 4 different analog inputs for this device, and 5, 6, 7 pins are 3 hardware address lines. So these 3 hardware address lines decides slave address of ADC or DAC device. And 8th pin is the device ground pin, and 9 and 10th pins are I2C communication lines, which are SDA and SCL. So with the help of these two lines, we are going to communicate with the masters. Here SDA stands for serial data line and SCL stands for serial clock line. And 11, 12 are oscillator and external pins, so which allows external clock cycles to this ADC device. But this PCF8591 has internal oscillator, so there is no need to use these two lines. And whenever you are looking the same device as DAC purpose, so use this analog ground and analog out. And V reference is the voltage which will act for your, which will depends on your analog four analog inputs. And VDD is the power supply pin for this device. And this PCF8591 works with 5 volts DC operating voltage. So this is the simple description about the 16 pins. So finally, PCF8591 supports 4 analog inputs with 3 hardware address lines. Because of these 3 hardware address lines, you can work with one I2C bus with 8 multiple ADCs by connecting different connections with this A0, A1, A2. And there are 8 possibilities here. You can do your hardware connections as by connecting complete ground, the logic is zeros, and by connecting one pin for VCC, you can change the logics of these 3 hardware address lines. And 8th pin is the ground. So finally, it allows 4 analog inputs and 1 digital output. You have to get your digital data from this SDA line by sending clock cycles from master to slave. And when, how can you use the same device for DAC purpose? Apply your digital data to this SDA line and you will get analog out from this 15th pin. By working with this A out and A ground, you can use for with as a DAC device. And PCF8591, this is the complete description about individual pins. AIN0, AIN1, AIN2, AIN3, these are the 4 analog inputs. And A0, A1, A2 are 3 hardware address lines. and VSS is the ground, and SDA, SCL are two I2C communication lines, oscillator input and output, external switch for oscillator input, and analog ground, V reference voltage, and analog out, positive supply voltage. And this is the most important thing you have to know about, how to deal with this I2C device. Until unless you don't know this slave address, it is not possible to deal with this I2C ADC device. So 1001 is the fixed part from this device. That means 1001, which is equivalent to 9, and A2, A1, A0. So these three are hardware address lines. Based on your hardware connections, you can decide the logics of these three. And the last bit, which is LSB, which decides whether you are doing read operation with this ADC device or write operation with this ADC device. So read write, which is 0, which allows write operations, and if it is 1, which allows read operations. And this is the interfacing circuit I can approach with this ADC device. So use your, based on requirement, use your channels, number of channels from this ADC device, and decide your A0, A1, A2 and ground connections. So if you are not fixing this either ground or VCC, it is not possible to decide slave address. And SCL, SDA, these are the two lines I am going to connect with master, which is 8051 as my case, and this is the slave as a I2C device, and external. So I'm not going to use this external, so I'll go with connection. So A ground and A out. So these are the two DAC lines. Whenever you're using DAC purpose, use these two lines. And reference, you have to set the reference as a minimum half of the positive supply what you are giving to this VCC line. And this ADC device, so which works with a specific data frame, which is, as long as you have to decide with the help of this control byte, so you can decide which channel you are using from this, and either you are looking to ADC purpose or DAC purpose. So this complete information you have to send through this control byte. So this control byte, the first two LSB bits which are used to decide which channel you are using from this ADC device. If you are giving 00, which allows channel 0. If you are giving 01, which allows channel 1. And 10, channel 2. 11, channel 3. And this is the third bit which is help us to auto increment the flag. So if you are looking to activate channels, then you can depend on this. And next bit is unused. And these two bits allows the four channels in differential mode or single ended. 00, I can use four channels in a single ended inputs. But whenever you are changing the logics of these two bits as 01, then one channel will work as reference and other channels works in differential mode. So these are the three comparators they are going to use to in differential mode. And 10, only channel 0 as a single ended, and analog 2 input 3 and analog input 2 and 3 which are works in differential mode. And 11, so only you will get two channels from this ADC device, analog input 0 and analog input 1, which provides channel 0 output. And the next bit which is help us to decide analog output enable or disable. So if you are making 0 here, so which will enables your analog output, and if you are making 1, this bit, so which allows DAC activities. So this is a control byte of ADC device. So as a data frame, you have to send this DAC, you have to send this information to this ADC device by following this data frame. So this data frame is very important to this device. So you have to call a start condition. So start is the protocol initiation, that means communication initializing condition is the start, and so this is the function to send your device address. After sending device address, so you have to send control byte, and this control byte decides which channel you are using and whether you are using DAC or ADC, and then so you can send your digital data from master to slave, and from your A out pin you will get your analog out. And if there is any acknowledgement problem, then I'll show error indication. Otherwise, so I'll go for stop subroutine. So this is the simple protocol implementation by using 8051 as a master and I2C ADC is a slave. And how to read the data whenever you are using as a ADC, as a PCF 8591. So this is the start, and this is the function I'm going to call to send the address of slave device. And then if anything, if what is C is equal to 1, this is the acknowledgement verification from master to slave to master. So this slave which responds with acknowledgement 0, then only I will proceed for next byte. If C is 1, then I will stop my communication by showing error indication. And this is the function I'm using to send each byte. And now, so this is the continuation. A indicates continuation of this flow chart, and this shin is the subroutine to read the data from ADC to master. And as a master has to provide acknowledgement by calling this acknowledgement function. So I'll do this continuously. So whenever I'm reading the data from ADC device. So this is a simple flow chart which allows to deal with ADC or DAC. Thanks for watching.